यूनिवर्सिटी राजस्थान टेक द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू वेलकम ऑल ऑफ यू अलोंग विद अवर एस्टीम्ड गेस्ट फॉर दिस सेशन टुडे लिव योर पैशन टू शेप योर फ्यूचर. एज समवन राइटली सेड एंड कोटेड, पैशन इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन हैविंग अ जॉब और हैविंग अ करियर. आई एम प्रिविलेज्ड टू इंट्रोड्यूस अवर पैनलिस्ट फॉर टुडेज सेशन, मिस्टर कृष्ण गुप्ता, CEO and MD, Organic Wellness Products Private Limited, a gold medalist from LIT Nagpur in chemical engineering. Mr. Gupta started his career in India with Colgate-Palmolive in 88. He has worked in companies like Gillette, Godrej, Benckiser in India. And he has also handled few critical assignments in Europe and USA. From 1999 to 2001. He has worked as project manager for multinational companies in Brussels, where his agenda was to improve the level of efficiency in the company. Mr. Krishnan believed in shaping his skill regularly and thus added few qualifications. Executive Marketing Management from IIM Calcutta, MBA, Lead Assessor ISO 22000 and instructor in Gemba Kaizen AOTS Japan. And he is also an esteemed alumni of MIT University. He is a hard taskmaster and he believes in leading from the front. Mr. Krishna always believes in win-win situation. He loves to read and play golf. He has also written a book, Clear Your Bottlenecks, which is basically developed to describing his recipe of success. We welcome you, sir. To take the session forward, we have with us our own Professor Dr. Amit Jain, Pro Vice Chancellor, Pro President, Dean, Faculty of Management Studies and Director, MIT Business School, Jaipur. Dr. Jain is also a visiting professor to University of Technology, Sydney, Celia Jonas University, Slovakia. Professor Jain holds PhD from Sardar Patel University. He is a member of All India Management Association and IIM Ahmedabad Alumni Association. He is actively involved in teaching, training, research, and is associated with various management and training institutes such as Bank of Baroda Staff College Ahmedabad, Management Association, ICFI University, Sardar Patel University, and NCHMCT. He has also received several awards and 3 research papers at national and international conferences. We welcome our esteemed panel for today. Over to you, sir.
Thank you so much, Vinodji. First and foremost, a very warm welcome to our esteemed speaker for the day, my co-panelist, Mr. Krishan K. Gupta ji.
Thank you, sir.
Welcome to you, sir. Namaskar. And I must compliment Vinodji to you also for picking up a very, very wonderful topic. In fact, a topic which is very close to even my heart. And the topic says that live your passion to shape your career. Right? What a wonderful theme. Because what I believe is that you cannot make a career. I mean, you can make a living, but you cannot make a career unless until you are passionate about what you are doing in life. So my compliments to you. A warm welcome to all the attendees of this webinar from MIT University Rajasthan, from MIT Universe, and all over the world who are watching it live also. To start with the deliberations, we have a lot to learn and know from Mr. Krishan Gupta, because his life in itself is a story, you know, worth talking and sharing about. But before we know that, I would like to present my perspectives also on the theme. And as a professor of marketing and entrepreneurship, I believe that you need to differentiate. Unless until you are able to differentiate from others, you cannot survive. So, you know, it is said that it is like distinct or extinct. So if you can't differentiate, you can't move beyond the obvious. And when you don't move beyond the obvious, you don't do miracles, either in life or, you know, career. So it is very, very important to have some kind of a differentiation. And when we talk about this differentiation, this differentiation has to be in your thought process also. And that differentiation in your thought process, that is ability to think different. You know, I'm not marketing Apple here. That ability to think different comes when you are passionate about something. And that is what, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to talk about today and know from the expert, right? In terms of talking about the passion or how that passion comes, I do a lot of career counseling, being a professor and an administrator at a university. And I talk to many students, and often they come and say and ask me that, sir, what kind of course I should do? What are the trends? You know, where are the great job opportunities, and which course I should enroll in? And in most of such situations, my answer is that opportunities are limitless everywhere. It depends on you, that what your passion and what your interest is. So for a management professional or for a technocrat or for an architect or a pharmacy or a biotechnology graduate, I mean, just name a field where we can say that there is no potential. In fact, I was talking to one of my friend who works with a technical a lead IT and consulting firm. And I was just talking about the, you know, future of jobs and the career opportunities and all that. And they said that, sir, we get, as of now, engineers in abundance. But what we now need is more of the creative people who can think and who can convert these ideas or creativity into words and help us document wonderful reports. So there is a great requirement for people who are kind of copywriters or people who are content developers also. And now if I look at from academics perspective, probably there is a great requirement for people who are simply, you know, be honors in English or be a French or MA in English. Now, so opportunities are endless. It all depends that to what extent and to what depth you are able to go into a field. You know, Mahatma Gandhi said that live as if you were to die tomorrow and learn as if you were to live forever. So learning never ends. And if you are passionate about something, you keep on learning every day. You keep on improvising every day. And that's what makes you successful. You know, a leader's courage to fulfill his vision comes from passion and not position, as said by John C. Maxwell. And I really like this quote because, yes, it is not the position that determines the success. It is the passion that determines the success. I'm a fan. I follow Swami Vivekananda a lot, as you can see. And Swami Vivekananda said that, take risks in life. If you win, you can lead. If you fail, you can guide. So I believe success is there in everything that you do. Even if you fail something, you may not earn money, but you earn a lot of experience. And probably that experience one day will help you to make a lot of money. So there is a lot that can happen when we are passionate about something. You know, passion is the energy. Krishna Guptaji, you also have done a lot of work in the Central India. And Gupta Sahab, I also come from Central India, from a very small town in MP, Ratlam. And we did all our education, the college and PG from Indore. And I still remember, and I'm just sharing this incident with you because it also relates to some extent to passion. We used to often travel during our college days from Indore to Ratlam. And these were not the typical days of air-conditioned, coaches or the reserved sleeper class also. So we will typically, you know, with a bag in hand, hop on to the general compartment. And most of the times, there will not be even a space to keep both the foots properly, you know. And sometimes we will end up standing on 1.5 foot only and reach to the destination. And I still remember the kind of pain that we used to feel after just half an hour. In fact, you know, you start from Indore and probably by the time you reach Pithampur and you start feeling the pain in your legs, that how difficult this journey is, right? And it was very difficult for us. The journey used to be of around 3.5 hours, 3 hours or so. And it used to be so painful. Gupta Sahab, I've been in teaching for almost 20 years. I'm a corporate trainer. I do a lot of training programs for different corporates. And these days, when I do a training program, a typical corporate training program that I do is of around 3 to 5 days. And on a particular day, I start my training at 9 a.m. in the morning, and typically I end at 6. And which means that I end up spending almost 8 hours in a day, practically, except those two tea breaks and half an hour of lunchtime. Because as a teacher, as a general habit, I can't teach when I'm sitting.
Mm-hmm.
I need to be interactive with all my participants. And then one day I thought that, you know, that half an hour of journey or that 2 hour of journey used to appear so painful to me. But today, even when I stand for 6 hours in a day, I don't feel that pain in my legs. And that is what all this passion is about. Because I'm passionate about teaching. I'm passionate about interacting with people. I'm passionate about talking to people. And that gives me the energy. That gives me the courage. And that gives me, you know, that motivation to go on with the training program, be it 6 hours or 7 hours in a day and for 3 days or 5 days. So that is what passion is all about. So, you know, I'll end my address with one last quote, which says that passion is energy. Feel the power that comes from focusing on what excites you. So if something excites you, you will never be required to work. Work will automatically happen. You know, you will simply, you know, sail with the wind as it goes, right? You just keep on doing work and what work will automatically happen, because practically you are not working. Actually, you are enjoying doing that bit. Okay, so that is what I wanted to share, my perspective on the theme, which is live your passion to shape your career. I believe career opportunities are endless. There are ups and downs in the field of business, but entrepreneurship as a field presents a big opportunity. In fact, what we have been talking about as entrepreneurship, as professors, government is now talking in terms of Atmanirbhar Bharat. And that's what the crux or essence of the entire policy of government is. And in entrepreneurship domain also, there is a lot that can happen when we talk about social entrepreneurship or social businesses. So, Guptaji, I'm so pleased to share that at MIT University Rajasthan, we have created a Yunus Social Business Center. And this we have set up with Professor Mohammed Yunus, Nobel laureate of the Grameen Bank fame. And because I was going through your website and your profile also, and I found that most of your work is also something which relates to the grassroots level people, to farmers. So on those lines only, sir, as a university, we not only, you know, believe in giving great placement opportunities to all our students, but we believe in making them job creators also. So from job seekers to job creators, we believe a lot in entrepreneurship. At Yunus Social Business Center, our focus is on helping students to create social businesses. Because what we have seen during this pandemic, now so many workers, they have migrated to their own place. And we don't know when they'll be able to come back, when life will become normal. And I strongly believe that, in fact, that should not happen, because again, we are back to that same routine otherwise. The best bet to take advantage of this situation or convert this adversity into opportunity is that we should be able to create job opportunities for these people at the places where they belong to. And probably that is what the essence of social entrepreneurship or social business is all about. In addition to that, we are a global university. We have programs which are in state-of-the-art domain. So we have engineering, architecture, biotechnology, fashion. I mean, you can think of a program in that we have. So definitely for these students also, we have started with MIT Innovation Incubator, which is our in-house incubation facility. We started with this facility in January 2020, and our objective is that every year we should be able to incubate somewhere around 50 to 20 businesses. In fact, we initiated the process, and when we did our first ideathon, which was a contest to develop the ideas, I'm so pleased to share that almost 300 business ideas were developed by our students. And now we are really finding it hard that, I mean, which 15 ideas to pick up to help them convert that into a business or a enterprise. So that's what our focus as a university, as a brand is. You're not an outsider. You have been part of MET system, so you know it. This is where we are slightly different from a routine university or a routine college, because we believe in entrepreneurship. We believe in innovation. Our chancellor is passionate about innovation. In fact, we celebrate his birthday as Innovation Day, because entrepreneurship is driven by innovation. And since you have been in a very, very innovative field, you have again done something which was not done earlier in India. I believe we would like to know from you about your journey, your experience first, and then we will take up the questions from our students. Over to you, Mr. Gupta.
Thank you so much, Professor. Thank you so much, Vinodji. And thank you, Amethi, for this invite. And my pranam and my namaskar to all the fellow students who are there listening to it, what I'm sharing. And I'm going to share with you practically what I'm doing as of now. And I'll start from the day I had thought of starting organic wellness. The reason for thinking about this business was because I always felt India has got amazing, amazing resources of herbs. If they use properly, and from where I got excited, because I have been to China and some of these countries like Singapore and all, where traditional Chinese medicine, TCM, is amazingly popular. I said, if TCM is amazingly popular, why can't India's medicine be so popular? And the best part was, wherever I tested, tried my products with these people who are using TCM, they had a wow effect. They said, this is 1,000 times better than what I was using, what they were using. The problem was, again, coming back to the roots of the issue, which most of the people have, is this authentic? Is it pure? Unfortunately, hum is desh mein apne haldi bhi pure milna hai to badi mushkil hai, doubt karte hain. और हर्ब्स की बातें तो आप छोड़ दीजिए. तो एक तरफ इंडिया लेगेसी इज देयर और ओवर 5000 इयर्स विद वंडरफुल योर यूनिक सॉल्यूशंस टू द टफेस्ट ऑफ प्रॉब्लम्स यू हैव अ सिंपल सॉल्यूशन. बट वी डोंट बिलीव बिकॉज अनफॉर्चुनेटली द ऑथेंटिक प्योर प्रोडक्ट्स आर नॉट अवेलेबल. अब आप प्योर हल्दी नहीं खाएंगे तो आप ठीक नहीं हो सकते. इंस्टेड ऑफ आप हल्दी को बदनाम करने के, आप उसको बदनाम करिए जो प्योर उसको नहीं दे रहा. इट्स लाइक एस्ट्रोलॉजी. इफ एस्ट्रोलॉजर इज नॉट करेक्ट, डोंट रबिश द एस्ट्रोलॉजी एज अ साइंस. यू आर विद द रॉन्ग पर्सन. सो फर्स्ट फोकस फॉर मी वॉज, वाई कांट आई कम अप इन दिस पर्टिकुलर फील्ड एंड कम अप विद ऑथेंटिक प्रोडक्ट्स. बिकॉज आई न्यू वन थिंग वेरी क्लियरली, ओवरसीज ह्यूज डिमांड्स आर देयर, पीपल आर डाइंग टू हैव ऑथेंटिक प्रोडक्ट, अ कंपनी विच अ ट्रस्ट, ethics and integrity of high standards. Number two, coming back to India, when you have to do these basics work, I thought, let me go to the toughest place where so far there is nothing done. If your lands are virgin, I look forward to, places in Maharashtra somewhere, Amravati, couldn't find something. Then we finally zeroed on a place called Village Babai. मैं वहां से नहीं आता हूं, मेरा कोई वहां से रिश्तेदार नहीं है, दूर दूर तक कभी सपने में भी वो गांव मेरे रडार पे नहीं आया. इट वॉज अकॉलिंग बाय दैट विलेज, वी वेंट ओवर देयर. पानी नहीं है, बिजली नहीं है, नथिंग टू लिव ऑन. एंड आई से वी विल सेट अप अ प्लांट इन दिस रिमोट विलेज. एंड वी बॉट अ 2.78 एकर्स ऑफ लैंड विदाउट नोइंग कि वहां पर 3-4 बजे पूरा सुनसान हो जाता है, लोग डर के मारे घर से बाहर नहीं निकलता. इट्स नॉट अ गुड एरिया टू बी इन एज पर दी लोकल कंडीशंस. और वहां प्लांट लगाना, वो भी कोई गुड़गांव से जाके वहां बैठ जाए किसी बेसिक समझ के. वी वेंट टू द बैंकर्स फॉर अ लोन. वी सेड इट्स अ ग्रेट अपॉर्चुनिटी, ग्रेट बिजनेस प्लान, वो बैंकर ने हमें नीचे ऊपर देखा, बोलता है आप समझदार होशियार इंसान लगते हो, प्रोफाइल अच्छी है, आपको किसने सलाह दे दी यहाँ प्लांट लगाने की, यहां तो आपको लूट के ले जाएंगे या आप हमें लूटना चाहते हैं बैंक्स को। मैं जब उनकी बातें सुनी कि वहां पे कुछ नहीं होता है, वहां तो सुसाइड रेट्स बहुत ज्यादा हैं, वहां पर बिजली नहीं है, पानी नहीं है, आई सेड यस दैट इज द लैंड आई वांट बिकॉज आई कैन रियली ग्रो ऑर्गेनिक प्रोडक्ट्स, वी कैन गिव एम्प्लॉयमेंट टू द लोकल पीपल ओवर देयर, वी कैन वर्क विद द फार्मर्स हु हैव डन नथिंग ऑन अ क्लीन वर्जिन लैंड सो दैट वी विल बी एबल टू हैव ऑथेंटिक बीइंग प्रोड्यूस्ड देयर। वो सर मदर टेरेसा मत बनो। So that was a motivation to me. There are two ways to look at it. You know, यदि वो बोलता था अच्छा है सब है करे तो मैं सोचता था यार कि पता नहीं। When he said some negative I said I've chosen the right place. Then I went to the industry's office, DIC. There I met Mr. Pandey. I would say among all the people I met, he was one person who said, Mr. Gupta, you have done the right choice. You have the right place and you will be successful. I said, चलो भाई लाखों में एक बंदे ने तो हमें पॉजिटिव बोला, बट इट हार्डली मैटर्स टू मी बिकॉज आई बिलीव्ड इन व्हाट आई वाज गोइंग फॉरवर्ड टू। द रीजन वाज वेरी वेरी क्लियर, आई न्यू द इंडियाज लेगेसी कैन नॉट बी रॉन्ग। यदि मैंने प्योर हल्दी उगा दी सर वो रिजल्ट देगी। मेरे को गाली मत देना फिर ऋषि मुनियों को देना, और मेरे को पता है ऋषि मुनि गलत नहीं हो सकते। आई वॉज ऑल्सो वेरी कॉन्फिडेंट अबाउट द फ्रंट एंड India's entrepreneur skills. Sir, India में जो entrepreneurship है, चाहे वो एक रिक्शे वाला हो, sir, for me is an entrepreneur. एक ठेले वाला हो, मेरे को पता है, is an entrepreneur. And there are thousands of women sitting at home for unknown reason, for some constraint. And I was very clear, I have to align with these 5,000 women in India in next 3 to 4 years. So I had a backup plan as far as the back. You know, background is concerned, the products, authentic, organic, go to the remotest village. Make sure every product you produce is authentic, organic, and supporting the lives of the poor farmers over there. Giving employment to the villagers over there. And let me pull out some of these pictures. This is, you can see the farmers meeting. This is where the beautiful plant you can see. This is one of the most modern plant we have set up over there. And these friends of mine, the so-called illiterate, uneducated, no one is above 10th, above not 10th, 10th is very big, maybe 5th or 6th standard. And for me, they are the best people I have come across in my life. I'll talk more a bit as we move forward. Now, when we started this, again the challenge was, sir, CCTV camera lagwa lo, aap wahan hai, 2 saal mein wahi tha, shuru mein plant lagaya, mehnat kari, establish kiya, and we were very clear, we'll establish state of the art, the best plant as possible, and we did it with style. Ab jab plant chalane ka aaya mauka to wahan pe light hi nahi hai, so then the suggestion came, simplest is use the diesel generator. I said, I'm not here to pollute the environment. We invested a lot of money and took the high tension connection of 33 kVA. We are invested a lot of money and we pay a lot of high bills, but we want to make sure we keep the village clean. Coming to the manpower, people said, aapko sir manpower to Delhi se lani padegi. Maine Delhi se lana tha to main yahan kyun aata, maine yahi bacche chalayenge. So called again, I'll repeat, 5th 8th standard upper limit, wo bhi gaon ka padha hua. I said, here is a machine, kuch imported thi, kuch local.
I think you got muted, Mr. Gupta. Haan ji, headphone ek baar wapas se connect kar lijiye please.
Can you hear me?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay. Sorry. So when we started the plant, the operators, I said machine today ki koi baat nahi. But I am not going to have any skilled person from Delhi, Mumbai, big cities. The reason is this plant is dedicated. As I said, I took the harder decision, but I believed in everything what we did. The same person who had no idea iska gadda khodna aur plant mein aake khada hai, sir, today they are the best operators I've ever seen. They maintain the best machine they have seen. And ताइवान में वो अपनी भाषा बोल रहा है, इंडिया में बुंदेलखंड में अपनी भाषा बोल रहा है, लेकिन मेरी मशीन ये अभी व्हाट्सएप वीडियो इन पे ठीक कर देते हैं. प्रोडक्टिविटी इज ऑफ द हाईएस्ट ऑर्डर. वी डोंट हैव अ सीसीटीवी कैमरा, वी डोंट हैव फ्रिस्किंग, इट इज अ कंपनी रनिंग टोटली ऑन ट्रस्ट. I don't have any relative running the plant over there. It's the local villagers who run the plant. I said, आपका प्लांट है, अपना समझ के चलाइए, नहीं चलाओगे चोरी करोगे आप जिम्मेवार. And I take pride in telling one of the best run plant I have seen in my life. I worked with the best of multinationals in India and across the world. And I take pride in what we are doing over there. From that plant, that remote local village, we are exporting products to 28 countries. And whoever has visited that plant, when they meet the people, they see the location, how interior it is, they get really swayed with the initiative and the story what Organic Wellness has created. It's about making a difference in the lives of one and everyone, starting everyone in the chain, starting from Mother Earth to farmers to team members to customers and associates as a whole. So that's a story on the backside, on the front end. I said, I'm not going to have a company with a lot of sales force. Because I'm not selling anything. You need a sales force if you want to sell something. I'm not selling anything. I'm not going to advertise. Because there is nothing wrong. There is nothing I have to fool people. Advertisement means what? आप सात दिन के अंदर सात सेवन वीक में आप गोरे हो जाओगे. अरे यार 60 साल से देश पूरा गोरा हो गया होता आज तक. So I'm not in the business of fooling the people, of just saying something and fooling. No. I said, this will be a company with zero sales force. It is the experience which people will share. Not easy. Very tough. But again, I believed in what we were doing. We said we will connect with the partners in such a way. Number one, it will be 100% advanced working, whether it's India or across the world. Number two, we will align with the people who have used the products and benefited. We clearly believe, we say, istemal kariye, ghutnon ka dard hai, jodon ka dard hai, kisi ko diabetes hai. I still have to come across a family in our country or across the world which has not issues. Sir dard ho gaya, tension ho gaya, diabetes ho gaya, kisi ko patla hona hai, kisi ko mota hona hai, thousands of challenges are there in daily life. Aur upar se ye sone pe suhaga covid aur ho gaya. Mere ko pata nahi covid kya hai. I don't know what is a mask, what is a sanitizer. I still don't know. Nor in my company people know. Because we are following our basics of life. Immunity is always strong. And you would have seen people who are living in Mahal with every possible distancing and mask and sanitization, they are getting the COVID, not the people in my village and not the people like me who are working 24 hours. The point I'm trying to say is the immunity levels which every family in our country needs to be improved. The challenges of health every family has, and it starts with basic of authentic pure products. Beet oil, humne oil banaya, raw cold press, hum refine nahi karte. दालें हमने बेसिक चलाई जो कि देसी बीज की और हाथ की चक्की से हमारी चाची चलाती है. 12 रुपए किलो उसको दे रहे हैं. वी आर मेकिंग अ डिफरेंस इन अ लाइफ. एंड हम लोगों को बोल देते हैं भाई घर में बीन लेना नहीं तो कंकड़ जाएगा दांत टूटेगा. द पॉइंट इज देयर इज आल्सो साइंस सर. जस्ट रन थ्रू दिस 50 ग्राम्स ऑफ दाल फ्रॉम योर आईज. यू आर गेटिंग योर आई एक्सरसाइज. We don't want to run through the machines and sawtex. We want to make a difference in the life of that woman by giving 12 rupees a kg and not by giving to the sawtex machine, which will be done at 50 paisa only. And believe me, my partners, my customers, my distributor across the world, they are delighted with the product. They say 50 grams hum paar kar lenge, boss, but it is making a difference in the life of unknown women. Same is the case with our supplements and teas and the complete range of over 170 products. Now we are connected with women who are sitting at home, women who want to start a store, and it is profitable from day one. It is for entrepreneurs to start the store it is profitable from day one because you are not selling the product, you are sharing your experience. Most importantly, I never felt that I have to chase money because I believed in one thing, which was jahan par meeta hai, wahan par cheeta hai. Jahan meeta hai, wahan par cheeta automatically aayega, and that is what my belief was, and that is what we are continuing always. Our belief is by every product we sell, it has to support the marginalized farmers we are working with. It has to support the children who are given the job in that plant. It has to support the customer because he or she should feel the benefit of the product. It is unique and authentic. The associate, the entrepreneurs, the distributors, the partners who have joined our, you know, momentum of selling the product, they have to make money. And I'm sure when all four in the chain make money, eventually I will also end up making money. So in short, it's a company with a purpose, it's a company with a cause, and we have a big vision of together, let's heal the world. Focusing on even our logo, it's about wellness. Green is for organic, blue is for wellness, and it's a healing hands. And that's what I say, together, let's heal the world. This is it in short, from my side. If any questions are there, queries are there, I'll be too happy to respond.
Excellent. I'm sorry I got disconnected. So I had to connect on my mobile. Am I audible?
Yeah.
Yes, I can hear you, Professor.
Okay. Thank you. So very interesting, in fact. And I must share here that the aspect that you talked about that touched most to me is that you are very much, concerned about the social well-being. You know, and the best part was that you didn't even use the generators, the very first decision, because I understand how long it takes in order to take a 33 kVA line in India. I faced it with one of the Greenfield University project I was working with, mm-hmm. where we had to run the entire campus for almost 6-7 months on a DG set because there was no electricity available, and it took almost 7 months to get the substation there. So things are difficult, but that's the best part of your journey, that you have never compromised on some of the basics, the basic foundations on which the entire business is planned, what we call as the organic business. And you have taken care of almost each and every part of the environment, of the society, of the people in and around the locality. There is one more common thing here, Mr. Gupta. I was born in Tikamgarh.
Oh, amazing. Our district is Tikamgarh.
And I moved maybe from there when I was just 4 or 5. So mm-hmm. No memories at all. I just remember the name that I heard. My father was posted there. And I very well know that this area used to be an area of a lot of dacoits.
So you go over there, now you'll know it's a greatest area where organic wellness plant is up and running. And
so I believe, that's the major challenge. It would have been really a tough decision, as you said, that the banker said that, have you gone mad? I mean, why you want to go to the place? Maa to aapko din mein loot liya jayega, because I know that area used to be like that, right? So, but when we make social changes, we change the entire, the social fabric of that particular area. And once they have more employability, they have employment opportunity, probably that problem also would have, got sorted out. And that's where the contribution of entrepreneurs like you, who work in social entrepreneurship domain, who work in businesses which are at the grassroots level, are very, very important.
Professor, one thing, the real challenge was there for first couple of months because the trust factor was not there. The problem was always this mistrust was there. Ye all the way Gurgaon se yahan kyun aa rahe hain? Yahan log nazdeek 15 kilometer dur se nahi aate dekhne. Ye Gurgaon se yahan par aake kya karenge? समझे तो द ट्रस्ट फैक्टर वाज द इशू. ये यहाँ पे कोई गलत काम करेंगे, But the moment they realize there's a huge plant coming over there, visitors from Europe, US, India started coming over there, and the local children of the local villagers, they started working in the plant, and then it was the best place for me. It's like the most safest and the most respectful place I have been in my life.
True. So we will take up some questions now. There was a question from one of our faculty also, that we are talking about passion and we are talking about shaping our career by living to that passion, living that passion. So now the question is that, let's say if one is good at multiple things, is able to do really well, how to understand that this is what my real passion is? And that's what we are talking about. Most of our young graduates and kids, they are really smart. They are all multitaskers. They are good in technology. They are good in their team building skills. They are good in other aspects also. So they all are multitaskers. How to realize, for example, if one has not yet felt or realized that what my real passion is? So what's your take on this, sir?
Sir, I'll be very upfront. You could be good at maybe many things. You could be fair, you could be good, but you are great only in one or two things. That's what my personal view is. There would be very rare individual who would be great at many things. Yeah, you could be good. I enjoy playing, football also. I enjoy playing tennis also, but I'm good in golf, but I'm not great. Again, I'm saying the difference. The moment you are great, you will be playing for the country. So same is the case as far as, your skills are concerned. I enjoy, I'm good at many things. I'm not. Now this business, what I've created, my passion, how it come up. I know it's my passion. No one has to tell me whether this is my passion or not. And nor I have to tell, because it is visible. Even when I'm talking, you will see the energy I carry. And this energy is there with me from morning 6 to 11 daily. I don't know what is Monday, what is Sunday, what is Rakhi, what is Eid. I have no holiday, nothing. Because for me, every day is a holiday. And the day I start working, that was one of the questions in our earlier seminar, that someone said that you have to work smart, you have to work hard, you have to work intelligently. I said, the day you think you're working, you're not an entrepreneur. You are not working, then you are moving from entrepreneur to an employee. So my take, again, just to repeat, sir, you can be great at one thing and you would know yourself. You don't have to ask anyone else. Think for 5 minutes coolly and you will have your answer within yourself coming up loud and clear that this is what you need to do.
I think there is a very interesting book by that name, Jim Collins, I believe, From Good to Great.
Okay. See, I'll tell you a very another simple example. Just taking my personal example, my son, he started his engineering in computers, because the pressure is there. Computer engineering. He's in the University of California. Within a year, he realized this is not what he wanted to do in life. He wanted to create games. He wanted to be in arts, and that's his flair is. And he moved on immediately. He said, no, this is not where I am. This is not what, because I don't have to tell him, this is something, it comes automatically, even for a student or a child. I'm sure it can come for most of us.
Very true. So, sir, if we talk about entrepreneurship now, and especially this is going to be for my young students. And as I said, that as a university, as an institution, we not only focus on, creating job seekers, but we focus on creating job givers also. So, what should be the road ahead, especially for my management students, if they want to do something in entrepreneurship? There is no shortcut to success, but still, can we get some quick 2-3 step guru mantras from your side, which they can follow and they can at least start their journey? A guidance or a mentor is very, very important when you are talking about the field of entrepreneurship or startups. And the maximum hurdle or the inertia they face is at the beginning stage, where they need to think. So they are now in a stage where they are thinking, they are attending most of these webinars, they are getting accustomed or tuned to the concept and philosophy of entrepreneurship. But how exactly, I mean, how they should move forward?
See, for me, I would say number one, entrepreneurship should not be a fad sort of a thing. You know, if 100 people are getting into this, you will find maximum get closed down. Okay. The reason I say, even today's time, you know, it's a very, very challenging time. Thousands of companies are there which are not able to operate. And the reason is there is nothing unique which is, there about a business. Like, for example, my field itself. If most of the people who want to start an organic company, what they do? They come to me, sir, can you pack my product? I'm giving practical examples. I'm sure your students will love it and understand. Even today, I had a discussion with a person, sir, can you pack my product? I said, I'll pack your product. Tell me one thing, why someone would buy your ashwagandha and not organic wellness ashwagandha? What will be the uniqueness? Ashwagandha packed by organic wellness. Why would someone buy your product? The lady had no answer. I said, think about it. Building a brand is not easy. Starting an entrepreneurship is not easy. So what I'm trying to say is, if someone is serious about this line, becoming an entrepreneur, let me tell you, it's not easy. Let me upfront, straight, direct. It is not a job. You have to really live it, breathe it 24 hours. And for first few years, poncha bhi aapko lagana hai. Xerox भी आपको करनी है, प्रिंटिंग भी आपको करनी है, लैपटॉप भी आपको चलाना है, ईमेल भी आपको चलाना है. यू हैव टू बी मास्टर ऑफ एवरीथिंग एंड यू शुड बी एंजॉइंग डूइंग इट. देर आर टू डिफरेंट थिंग. वन इज यार करना पड़ रहा है. नहीं, फॉर मी, आई एम इन अ फैक्ट्री, आई एम डूइंग लेबलिंग, सिटिंग विद माई टीम मेंबर्स, आई एम एंजॉइंग इट. आई गो देयर नॉट फॉर सीइंग क्या हो रहा है, आई गो देयर फॉर एंजॉइंग टाइम विद देम. I go there. Abhi, last time I was there, you know, we were packing our oil in 45-50 liters cans were there. Akela khada hua tha wo. Okay, maine chal bhai, main pack karwata hu. And for an hour or so, I was doing the packing, lifting 45 kgs drums with the guy, with my friend over there. Yes, I felt delighted after 2 hours saying, I'm very strong. I can, you know, do these work. That's a different thing, but it's a passion for me. So, entrepreneurship is a life you live on. It is not something ki main aa raha hoon, aaj kar raha hoon, uske baad then better to be an employee. If you believe in these things, what I'm telling you, and keep two things I always keep in mind. Keep faith or belief in yourself. And second is perseverance. Patience or perseverance and faith. यदि आपके पास ये दो तीन चीजों का समागम है, कॉम्बिनेशन है, सर, इससे बढ़िया लाइफ फुलफिलिंग अपॉर्चुनिटी नहीं है, स्पेशली इन करंट सिचुएशन इन आर कंट्री वेयर अपॉर्चुनिटीज आर इन्यूमरेबल. मैं जो कर रहा हूं आप रिप्लिकेट कर लीजिए किसी और विलेज में, मैं आपका साथ हूं, पूरा हर चीज में सपोर्ट करने को तैयार हूं. सो अगेन आई विल रिपीट, इट्स अ ग्रेट प्लेस टू बी इन to become an entrepreneur, but don't jump into because of a fad, don't jump into because your colleague or your friend or your neighbor jumped into it. Don't be into a suicidal tendency. See that you are ready to live this life and enjoy it. You will be successful. There is no one who can stop you from being successful. And I'm talking out of my personal experience.
Definitely. So, what was that turning point when you decided that, okay, enough of this corporate job? You have worked with some of the best brands in India, right? And you have been part of the corporate world. So, what was that turning point when Mr. Krishan said that, okay, enough of this corporate job and let me do something of my own?
There is an interesting story, actually. When I started my first job in a big multinational company, and it was like, I was a management trainee, you're a university gold medalist, you are in flying high, and my dad was there with me to drop me to the, you know, office. I'll not name the company, I'll not name anything. As we entered there, my dad says, now from today you will start fooling our fellow Indians. I was looking at my dad, yaar aadmi hai kya. He says, ye 20 rupaye ki cheez tum bhi 200 mein bechoge, logon ko nuksan karoge. Maine kaha, yaar बापू है क्या? I kept silent. He says, कुछ पर्पस के लिए काम करो, डू फॉर अ कॉज. आई इग्नोर्ड एक्चुअली, आई वॉज फ्लाइंग हाई. एक बंदा सेलेक्ट हुआ इतनी बड़ी कंपनी में, सो कॉल्ड मल्टीनेशनल, यू नो हाउ इट इज. शाम को मुंबई में मरीन ड्राइव है, वहां पर ले गए, तो वहां पर स्टीमर चल रहे थे. तो चलते चलते वो बोलते हैं, यू नो व्हाट इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग इज दिस स्टीमर. I said, yeah, diesel है, तो नहीं. Engine है. I said, water. He says, if water is not there, nothing will work. And if the same water enters this boat, what will happen? I said, it will sink. He says, great. He says, same is the case, but keep in mind, money is very important in our life. You have to sail on it, you have to enjoy it. But the moment it enters your heart, you will also sink. अब ये दो कहानी, रात गई बात गई, हम भूल गए यार. You know, style and, you know, enjoying life. But always it used to hit me. Whenever I'm sitting at peace, silent, yeah, dad was saying cause, work, purpose. And I started feeling what he was saying. And then I worked in a couple of companies at MD position, senior position. I was even partners in a few companies. But I realized I'm not doing something I'm living for. Something I wanted to do. And then this required coming out of your, you know, comfort zones. And that you can come only when you realize you have the belief and the, you know, and the, you know, tenacity to take this. And that's where I said, let me take a plunge. And I said, if I have to take this plunge, I have to be 100% authentic. And now I realize what my dad said about purpose, about the cause of your company. And I'm fulfilling it. That's where the uniqueness is. And that's where a unique story is. That's where it goes across the world to the people. It touches the life of everyone. And that's where organic wellness really moves month over month, year over year. And people are aligning not only in India, but across the world.
No, really interesting to know about this. Just a minute. So how long it was the corporate stint, and then almost for how many years now you have been?
Corporate stint would be about what? About 20 plus years, and organic wellness is about 6 years now.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
And it's a company which is no investors, no bank loans. It's a debt-free company, works on its own strength, survived all ups and downs across which come up in life. And we are on a really, really good trajectory, good path. And what really excites me is we've been able to establish that uniqueness, what organic wellness brings with it.
So, you shared that what were the problems when you actually started off. But then if I talk about the current state of affairs, the pandemic, the lockdown, so how it has kind of impacted your business and how you see things moving forward?
See, for me, number one, anything which is not in our control, I don't even care. Lockdown, not in my control. What to care? Okay, 2 days lockdown, enjoy sleep, enjoy the time. There's nothing you can do. You know, it's someone has taken a decision and there's nothing you can do, right? But as a business, for us, even lockdown is presented as huge opportunity. So I see lockdown as a big opportunity. A, people have realized sitting from home is a better option. People have realized I don't want to go to the stores much. What has done to us? People are sitting at home and operating my stores now. Ghar baith ke store khul raha hai. There are many people sitting at home earning about 30,000 to rupees 1 lakh per month. Selling organic wellness, becoming organic wellness partner from small villages, tier 2, tier 3, tier 4 cities. Forget about Delhi, Mumbai, Lucknow, big cities. I'm talking about small cities from Ramganj, Mandi to Meerut and other cities. So every challenge what has come during this lockdown period, for us it is presented an opportunity. Now, for me, if I had to say, you know, if the another opportunity, I would say the good part what we did 5 years back of setting up a plant in a remote village. If I was sitting with this plant in a big city, we would be in a major mess. We are in a remote village. It's the reverse. The children or the, you know, people are going back to the villages. So it's a reverse exodus as such. So for me, manpower is not a problem. As much as I need, the people are available over there. Fortunately, still the remote villages, people don't know what is COVID, what is Corona. In fact, when we went over there, some of my team members were having a mask. I said, "Mat lagao, pakad ke marega, pakad le pujega, kya aayega, chor aur aa gaya kya?" You know. And honestly, I was sitting at dhaba there eating with the panditji, the, you know, pakoda and samosas over there. Maine pucha unse, maine saab, panditji, kitne din dukaan dukaan band raha yahan pe? Bolta saab, hume sachchai bataye, ek bhi din band nahi hua. So lockdown, social distancing, these are great words for people sitting in front of television and all, but the people who are in the remote villages, the plant where we run, yes, we follow all the government guidelines, we follow all the respectful, whatever, you know, basics are to be done by the local level as well as, but as a business, nothing has stopped us. Every challenge has been taken as an opportunity, and we had the best of last 3 months.
So, in fact, what I understand that this is a very unique business model, because you are kind of integrating rural with digital, as you said that, a company with zero sales force. So, is the entire marketing done digitally? Can we see it as a good example of modern day digital or e-commerce business?
I would say, Professor, we don't do marketing. Basically, what we do is whatever is done is shared. Okay, like today, what I'm talking to you is being, you know, seen by many people. I'm sure some will get really, you know, encouraged by what we are doing. Okay, and I have seen one thing, sir. Everyone wants to do something good in life, and if they get a right channel, sir, they are bound to jump on it. Okay, now if we have a testimonial just now received from a Meerut guy that he had issues with his back and he took a joint fit kit. And he got fit. He sent a testimonial with the reports of a doctor what wanted. And now he has become my distributor in Meerut. He said, "Sir, yadi mere ko fayda hua hai, I would like this product to reach to everyone in my vicinity or in my area of influence." So this is what we are able to do. So to answer your question, yes, we do a lot of digital things, but we are not marketing. We are just sharing daily facts on the Facebook or the social media, wherever is applicable, and it takes off automatically.
So, not marketing per se, but then how the supply chain and distribution is managed? And
number one,
distribution, distributor model.
I'll tell you, we are letting this evolve automatically. We are letting. Because see, the traditional model of a CFA and the super stock is, see, you are eating out all the margins in the between with no addition, no value addition. Humne model banaya hai, bhai, sab chain kaat do. Get directly connected with the company and we give you a substantial margin and become our partner. For me, handling Meerut is similar to handling, say, Finland. I say, "Bhai, I have no idea how Finland works. What is the strategy over there? How you will work? I have no idea how Meerut will work. You are in Meerut. You know better Meerut than me. And here is a product which is my responsibility to give you at a X cost. Your responsibility to take it forward. You have tried the product, tested the product. It's unique. And what you have done is there is nothing. Even Aata is unique for me. Aap Aata try kariye Meera. You will find, you will see as different." So that's where we have taken a pride in creating a basket of product where we stand tall and different and better than the market forces what we see. So automatically people are creating their own channel. I'll tell you a company where we have stores also being operated. Retail is being operated. Traditional distribution is being operated. E-commerce is being operated. B2B is being operated. And we are letting the business evolve. I am not forcing this is your margin. This is no. You are an entrepreneur working with an entrepreneur. I believe you have better skills, you have got better knowledge than me. I don't believe in doing that. Even if a store is being created, we don't have a process, standard process or standard operating procedure. Yahan logo laga lo, ye board aisa laga lo. Nahi. Sir, you are an entrepreneur. You have better creativity than me. Use it. And I'm telling you, Professor Jain, it is mind-boggling when you say this to your friends. They say, wow, I can use my brain. I can do whatever I want. And I'm telling you, this is going places. People love being creative. And I don't want to do as a brand, logo yahi laga do, hara rang yahi laga do. Arey yaar, use whatever you like. At the end of the day, maal bech, paisa kama. Jisse jo uga raha hai, wo bhi khush. Jo kha raha hai, wo bhi khush. Jo bana raha hai, wo bhi khush. Tum bech rahe ho, tum bhi khush. Aur thoda aur, main bhi khush. And that is where we are letting it evolve. That is what entrepreneurship is, sir. Otherwise, I'm creating more employees.
Well said. So what are the expansion plans? I mean, where do we see Organic Wellness 5 years down the line now? How do we move forward?
Show you this. I don't know if it is visible.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yes.
This is what I see morning, evening. You know, morning, evening, this is what I'm seeing. This is my first target. Maybe
hopefully we do this sooner than later. And the next target then we are working on is to connect with 5,000 entrepreneurs across India. And you can multiply each doing a business of at least 2 to 5 lakhs of rupees. And you can multiply how much business we can do per month.
Great. This is what living your passion is all about.
That's what life is all about, sir. Create people, let them enjoy the life. And of course, you know, you be part of the wagon. And when it rains, we all will get wet.
Very true. Well said. So probably the last question for the day. We are almost at the end of the session now.
Yeah.
Now, assuming someone has a brilliant idea and is passionate about it as well, he supports his idea with all his effort and support. Now, how does he deal with the fear of getting his idea taken up at a larger scale by a corporate? So, you know, you have an idea. For example, how you see Organic Wellness competing with the, you know, FMCG organized big food brands, let's say for matter ITC tomorrow, they decide to get into organic segment. They've already got into atta and oil and all. So how do you see? So that's what this question is all about. That you have a great idea. You started with it. Fine. You've been there for almost 5-6 years now, but how do you, protect yourself from competition, that too from larger groups?
Sir, I'll be very upfront. I'm in this field, in this business from last 6 years. There are big names you're talking about. There are many more. Okay. To be honest, I don't even think. It's like main yahan rehta hun, sir. Barabar wale ke paas kaun si gaadi hai? Barabar wala kya kar raha hai? Mere ko matlab nahi. Main apni strength pe focus kar raha hun. Meri uniqueness hai. और मैंने सर जो मॉडल बनाया है प्रोफेसर जैन, वो इस तरह का है, अच्छा अच्छा कॉपी नहीं कर सकता. आई कैन टॉक वेरी ओपनली, बट सम ऑफ द नेम्स व्हाट यू हैव टॉक्ड अबाउट, दे हैव कम टू मी बिकॉज दे डोंट हैव अ पैशनेट टीम मेंबर्स. व्हाट वी आर एबल टू डू, एंड वी आर एडिंग नॉट एम्प्लॉय. आई वुड बी फियरफुल इफ आई वॉज एडिंग एम्प्लॉयज इन माई टीम. Sir, I'm creating many Krishan Guptas. Not only Krishan Guptas, they are in fact double, triple passionate than me. Whether you see my partner, you know, store owner in Jaipur, Dipali ji and Neetu. You see in Ramganj Mandi, sir, Preeti and Tia. You see in Rampur, you see in Meerut, this Sanjeev ji. You see in Guwahati, Priyan. You see in Indore, they are double, triple passionate than me. Sir, I'm not bothered. If I was hiring, I'll repeat the team members. I'll be worried. क्यों एक नौकर को लूँगा, एक employee को, उसके ऊपर एक supervisor लगाऊँगा, फिर उसको देखने के लिए एक और manager लगाऊँगा. Then I will be competing with these people. I have no ideas to compete with these, sir. My model is different. My target segment is different. My focus is different. My vision is different. And I want to make sure everyone who works with us, they should be the entrepreneur. They should be making more money. And as a business, if I take even 1 rupee out of 5,000, I make substantial money. That's what our focus is. So to again answer and say it, I focus on our strength. We focus on our pocket. We focus on our business. We focus on our vision. We focus on our uniqueness, and it takes us.
Well said. So probably one last question from one of the participants. So you are basically registered. You are a private limited company. Any plan to go public?
Yes. We would like to be a public in next 3 to 4 years. We will make sure every farmer who is an owner in the company. We will make sure every team member who is associated with the company is owner in the company. We'll make sure every store owner, every distributor in India across the world who has contributed to the growth of the business is made ownership in the company. Today is held 100% by me. We want to really dilute about 50% in the third or fourth year when we go for the public and reward every farmer, because when they open in the morning, they can see how their company is doing well. They are not dependent on me, because I know as sufferer many times being a partner in private companies, it is up to the owner to give you the money, how much value they will do. Here, I would like them to be the owners, to decide every day on a TV or newspaper, they can see what is the value of their company today. And that's what our clear plans are. God willing, we will do it. If not three, maybe in the 4 years.
Excellent. Mr. Gupta, all the very best for all your ambitious plans. And we sincerely hope that you will achieve it even earlier to that as you have planned. Thank you so much. It was a wonderful interaction. We enjoyed it a lot. There were a lot of learnings from your life journey itself. And we wish a great success to Organic Wellness.
Thank you so much to Professor Yu and MIT and Mr. Vinod, and to all your students. If I could be of any help, any support, I'm always available. You have my contacts with you, Christian@organicwellness.com. Feel free to write to me. Feel free to visit me. Feel free to visit our plant also. You're most welcome. And I'm sure you love the magic. And in case any one of you want to be part of the entrepreneur journey, what we have done, any one of you want to open a store anywhere in your city, anyone wants to do that, join me. You will love it.
Thank you so much. Look forward to your personal visit also to our campus. And you'll be also pleased to see the campus, because it happens to be one of the largest green and sustainable campus in Northern India. We have a 152-acre campus, and it's completely designed on the lines of sustainability. It's a zero water discharge campus. We don't waste even a single drop of water. We have solar farm and solar panels on all our roofs. So because of your inclination towards sustainability and organic and doing something good for society, I'm sure you will love visiting our campus also.
Anytime, sir. It will be an honor. It will be an honor. Thank you once again. Pleasure being with you all. Thank you so much.
Thanks a lot, God sir. Bless. Thanks a lot. And we have successfully come to an end of this wonderful session. Believe me, it was really, really a great session with two leaders of different industries in discussion. And it reminds me about a small story before we end up. There was an employee on day one, he was offered a bicycle from his HR manager. So he just saw the bicycle and he saw that there is no stand in the bicycle. So he went to the HR manager and said that, sir, there is no stand in the bicycle. So the HR manager said, okay, come back to me tomorrow. I'll give you the bicycle tomorrow. So he went back the next day. So he got that bicycle again. And now, surprisingly, he saw that the stand is there, but the carrier was removed. So he was surprised and said, sir, what is happening? So the HR manager said that if you want a carrier, then there should be no stand in it. So with these words, I really thank Krishan Gupta sir and our own Professor Dr. Amit Jain sir.